Hi, and welcome to this video. My name is Oliver. I work at onlinecity.io with development and integrations. In this video, I'm going to walk through on how to build a simple Java application that can send an SMS with Gateway API SMS. Let's begin. I'm going to show you how to code a very simple Java application that allows you to send an SMS through Gateway API SMS. Now, there are three things you're going to need. One is knowledge about Java to code. Two, how Maven works, because we're going to use a simple dependency. And three, a Gateway API account. Now, it's easy. Go to gatewayapi.com.eu, make an account, and buy some test credit. The way it works is we're going to need the API key. I have made a temporary token here because you're supposed to keep this safe, but I can't for the purposes of this video, so I'm going to delete this afterwards. Let's begin coding. So I'm going to guide you through how to do it. The first thing I'm going to do is store my token right here in a string. Now, don't store it in plain text like this, but this is of course just for testing purposes. Now, the first thing we're going to do, or I'm going to do, is build up the dependencies that we need for our post request. That is, we need an authentication header. And we are going to need the body. Now the authorization is very, very easy. It's just base64 encoding our token, appended with a colon, because we don't use the password part of that authentication. But it is very simple, so let's just do it. I am going to be using this piece of code to do it. Boom, store it in a string and say auth header equal to, so base64, we're going to import it, we're going to get the encoder, and then we're going to encode what exactly? Well, just our token plus a colon. We're going to, the encoder expects bytes, so we're going to encode it to a string. We're going to prepend basic plus, and this is already our header. Very easy. Let's just make a comment about the authorization header. The next thing we're going to need is the JSON body. And for this, I'm going to build up a JSON object, call it parent. Let's just call it body to be consistent. Now, if you read the documentation for our SMS endpoint, we know that we need a sender, we need a message, and we need some recipients. So let's just start with the sender. Sender, and I am going to say that the sender is Java. We also can specify and must specify a message, not with capital, mind you. Oh, message. And the message I'm going to say is example from Java. Last thing we're going to need is the recipients. Now, here we need an array of MSISDNs. So the way we do this is we put in a new JSON array in which we put a JSON object, not just any, but a new JSON object, in which we put our MSISDN and the number. Now the number needs to have the country code prefixed, so 45 for Denmark, for example, and then the number. I'm just gonna put in a dummy number here. So to kind of recap what I did here is we have a this last one is a key of recipients, and then we need an array. So here we are building the new JSON array in which we build a new JSON object which has an MSISDN and then the number. So it's going to look like this. And this is what we're building up. Now, if you needed another number, you could say we put this and then you need to do it again. You would actually have to store this somewhere to put another thing. You could make a function, you can do whatever. But this is a basic message. Awesome. Now we need to build up our request. And for that, we are going to use the, we're going to use a HTTP client dot new HTTP client. And for this, we are of course using the HTTP sub package from the .NET in Java. And this is the client that's shown to send the request. We also need a request, which I am going to say is a we again use the client, but we're going to use the new builder here, and then we're going to, sorry, not client, request and new builder. Now we need a URI, and the URI we are going to be hitting is the HTTPS gatewayapi.com/REST/mtsms. This is going to potentially throw a URI syntax, so we just throw this here. Might want to handle these in case you need to. And what we're going to do now is we're going to specify it's a POST request. And we are going to say that regarding the body, we're saying we want it to be of a string, and then we take our body here and pass it as a string. Cool. We're going to add a header, authorization header more specifically, and we're going to give our auth header. This ensures that we can be authenticated at the API. And just to be completely transparent, we can say the content type is application JSON. And we build it. Boop. And that's it. We're done. Now, the only last thing we need to do is we are going to get the response by saving the client and sending the request. And we are going to specify that the response is of a string. This means that we can receive it and get the string responses out. Now, this is potentially throwing a method signature to IO exception or interrupted. That's fine. And I'm just gonna shout the response dot status code and also the response body. And this is basically everything. All you have here in the main, you can see on the screen, is everything you need to know to actually send an SMS. So if I run this, we should be getting a message sent. And let me just confirm this by pressing run. And indeed, we did send a message. We have the ID of the message sent here. We sent one to Denmark, and it cost us 0.285 DKKs. Awesome. But now you've sent it. If you wish, you can go back to your Gateway API account. You can go to your traffic log, and you can actually see right here that we did send a Java example from Java. Awesome. So I hope that was an enlightening experience and that you are now capable of building a simple Java application that can send an SMS. If you need any further assistance or need to look through the documentation, be sure to visit gatewayapi.com. Bye for now.